Trish is going around asking for a prayer request. She's writing it down so that we keep everything in prayer. Praise God. So. So if you see her come around, she's not asking for your menu order. She's not asking that. She's asking for prayers. Okay? Don't say pizza. A Diet Coke. Can I get a Diet Coke with that? Huh? Yeah, no lasagna. Just prayer request for now. Praise God. We won't limit God. Just go ahead and put it on the list. You never know. Praise God. We're all living in the gooder and gooder. In Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. The family's all here. Praise God. So good to see you guys. Hallelujah. Our worship service this evening is titled, It Is What It Is. Amen. Now, I've got to confess to you, I did not hear this saying until I moved out here to Kentucky. And it's one of those sayings where it's like, it is what it is. Right? And it really moved on my heart because I got a couple brothers here at the church that say that quite often. It is what it is. And sometimes, Holy Spirit will move on my heart to say, pray for them because there's something going on in their life that they're struggling with. And they've accepted it as norm. And it is what it is. Right? And so, of course, after Sunday, I brought this to the Lord. And I said, Father, I want you to bless us with a message, as you always do. But I want to use this word. It is what it is. Amen. So I'm truly, truly excited as I always am, whether it's Pastor, myself, Elder Charlie that's preaching. We know Holy Spirit's doing preaching. Amen. And I ask for your prayers. They already prayed over me. For those of you who don't know, every worship service, we all go into prayer room and the leadership anoint whoever's speaking in oil and lay hands and pray over him. And it's something Holy Spirit asked us to do because I confess to you, in pride, say that word with me, pride.
Pride.
In pride, that's a scary, deadly thing now. Amen. I was deceived by the enemy through my own pride. And through true repentance and confession, I had to go to the Father and completely own up to everything. That I wanted a relationship with you, Father God, based on my terms. I wanted to worship you, God, based on my availability. I want to do things for you, God, but based on my schedule. And eventually, God turned me over to my pride. God said, you want nothing to do with me? God will never say he doesn't want anything to do with you. Don't let anybody tell you that. God pursues every soul in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
God will not stop. But God will give yourself over to yourself if you continue to be disobedient with him. Now remember, I'm not throwing anybody under the bus. I'm just telling you my business as a pastor, as a preacher. It was all about me, and I didn't want anything to do in true worship unto God. And it got to the point where my heart started to get cold. I started to judge people, openly judging people. Souls would come to me for comfort. Souls would come to me for a word from the Lord. But in return, all I would do is judge them and tell them what they're doing bad. May I tell you, they even know what they're doing bad. Right? What God is asking from us is to identify the fruit. You judge the fruit based on whatever they're struggling with, right? But to pray and speak life over that soul. Amen? Be a blessing, to speak life, to be the one that you are God's voice speaking into their life, and you're speaking life into them, hoping that Holy Spirit in them would go, let there be light.
Amen.
Amen. Now we all make our own decisions and our own choices. Can I get an amen?
Amen?
We all do. I mean, the truth of the matter is that if you make the same choices time and time again, but you're expecting different results, you will go down a road named insanity. If you're doing the same thing over and over and over again, but you're thinking that you're going to get something different, it's not going to work, Brother David. But if you're ready like me, every moment of every day, to bless God and be unfamiliar with God, even if I just go to Kroger, for crying out loud, Father, change the way I look at people. Father, guide my steps. Father, orchestrate wherever I go. Use me, Father God, that may I bless you in a way so that I can be a blessing to whatever soul that is observing. May I tell you that we are surrounded by souls that are watching. Right? I'm just going to tell you. I'm going to cut the devil's head off right now. There are so many souls hoping that open arms fails. Ain't that right, Pastor? There's so many souls right now hoping that Joey Grindin fails. I'm going to tell you right now. This is how I'm going to rebuke the enemy. I fail every day. Lord Jesus is the perfect one. And it's because my focus is on the perfect one that it doesn't matter that I fall every day. It's because my focus is on Him. It is what it is. I am a beloved child of God. I am forgiven. Amen. I am an overcomer. Hallelujah. I am worthy. Hallelujah. Because He paid it all in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Why don't you clap your hands? Okay, good. I'm just wondering. I was going to go over there for a minute. Gosh, I love you. So good to see you, sis. Praise God with you smiling and everything. Hallelujah. We're going to be in Psalms 51, verses 10 to 12, and we're going to be in Isaiah 40. Verse 31. Create in me a pure heart, O God, and renew a steadfast spirit within me. Oh, hallelujah. Now we got to remember, Brother David was writing this, not you, Brother David. Brother David, just stop talking real quick. I'm not picking on you. He was talking to Mama, and I said, Brother David, I love you so much. King David, right? Yes, King David, he wrote this. Now, you guys got to recall, he wrote this after he done the unimaginable with Uriah the Hittite. He set him up to get murdered because he wanted Bathsheba. Remember? This was the time. And this is what David wrote because he was in all this turmoil because he knew he did wrong. The prophet Nathan, if I recall correctly, Pastor, hold me accountable if I get this wrong. If I recall correctly, the prophet Nathan went to David and told him this story about there's this guy that had all the sheep, all the stock, right? All this flock. And then there is one guy who had one baby little lamb. And he loved that lamb, slept with it, and you know, just raised it with the family and fed it. And here comes this guy, and he took that lamb. Stolen. And if you continue now, reading in 2 Samuel, I believe that's in chapter 12. David said, bring him to me. Because David was going to put judgment on him. And then the prophet said, that's you. David, you did it. And it's after hearing the word from the Lord that he's like, and then Nathan continues to say, you could ask anything from God Almighty. Anything in your anointing, your relationship with Him, but you go and do this. And now you will eat the seed that you sow, right? You see, I'm not calling anybody perfect in this room because there's only one perfect one. His name is Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. However, beloved family, for us to start living the abundant, victorious life, we have to uproot some things. Say that word with me, uproot. We have to uproot some things. Now, some of these things that were planted, it may not even be from your lifetime. It may be from past generations. May I say that again? It may be from past generations of racism. It may be from past generations of lust, idolatry, unforgiveness. That's a big one. You ever had that growing up? Aunties and uncles don't talk to each other. You don't know why because you just born into it. Right? before you were born. What was it about? Oh, I forgot. Why are they still fighting? Can I get an amen?
Amen?
If there's somebody being crunchy right now, maybe that's you. Maybe that's you. You need to uproot this thing. I want to tell you right now that unforgiveness, whatever the devil put, is robbing you from a blessing. And God right now is asking you, will you eliminate that? It's up to you. Say it with me. It's up to me. See, we just celebrated, hallelujah, Easter. We just celebrated Easter. Now, granted, I heard from many, many souls this week. I live Easter every day. Every day is Easter. I know, praise God. That's right. We don't need a day to celebrate the resurrection power because we display that resurrection power. Amen? But when we ask God, create in me a pure heart, O God, and renew a steadfast spirit within me, this only comes based on according what the Word of God says. That if there is repentance, God promises, I'll create a steadfast spirit in you. I will create a steadfast, a new heart. How many of us want that? Do you want something new from the Lord tonight? Amen? Hallelujah, Brother Brandon. So right now, we have to choose. Listen, there's some of you, I know some of you are like, well, Brother Joey, my day was gooder and gooder. I did nothing wrong. I'm not talking about today then. Right? Have the Holy Spirit examine you. And as he shows you, oh, there it is, Father, forgive me. Forgive me that I still held something against that person, Father. Right? Change me, O Lord. Amen? It continues on saying this. Do not cast me from your presence or take your Holy Spirit from me. Listen to the heart of King David. Listen to the heart of this brother in his worship. He's known now after the guy after God's own heart, right? Man, that's a big title to have, right, Pastor, in the Bible? That you're known as the man after God's own heart. I mean, there's a lot of powerful men in the Bible, right? But you're talking about Old Covenant, Old Testament. Brother David was known that he was after God's heart. And here you could hear it. Because he knows he messed up. He sinned against the Lord. Right? How many of you are perfect? Raise your hand. Amen? There's only one perfect one. Hallelujah? So that means every one of us here tonight has something to offer God in worship. Whether it's during the altar call, whether it's up here at the front, or just doing it right now, right? Father, create in me a pure heart. Hallelujah. And he cries out to God saying, don't cast me from your presence or take your Holy Spirit from me. See, I believe strongly as a new covenant church, this is where we miss the intimacy that we have with God Almighty. We use Lord Jesus Christ as an excuse to live however we want to live. Yeah, because I know Jesus. Woo! That's a mouthful right there. Well, if you know Jesus, then why are you letting these things come into the body? Why are you looking at another woman when you should only have eyes for your wife? Why are you gossiping and complaining when you know that you should just keep that shut and just pray? I have Jesus. Now conviction. See, conviction is falling upon a lot of us right now. Right? We call on the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We say that we're saved, but yet behind closed doors, we act a different way. Acting like God doesn't know. May I call out your fruit? May I call out my fruit if I choose to live that way? War. Then I'm acting holy. Then I'm acting righteous. Then I'm acting so-and-so before you. But behind closed doors, I'm acting truly who I am. Powerful word, I am. What God is asking of us, can we be transparent with God? Amen? Let me ask you something. Why on Easter Sunday? The house is plumb full, over 200 something people. Right? But in there on a Wednesday, why? I got Jesus. Right? Praise God you're here. Amen. Give God praise for that. Hallelujah. Praise God you're here. You decided, you know what? I'm not playing that game. I'm not playing that game with God. David is crying out to the Lord, saying, do not cast your presence from me. Do not take your Holy Spirit from me. Praise God we have Lord Jesus Christ so that Holy Spirit lives in us. And God says, through the mouth of Lord Jesus Christ, don't quench Holy Spirit. Don't quench Holy Spirit. Which means when you know God is calling on you, when you know God is speaking to your heart, when you know God is saying, stop doing these drugs. Right? Stop getting high. I'm not judging nobody. But I'm telling you, that's how Holy Spirit speaks. Stop cussing. Right? Why is that? Because God's in here. And God knows everything that flows through His temple. And when He sees it, He's like, that doesn't belong here. So He gives you the power and authority to make the change in your beloved life. Amen? Let's make a change, church. Hallelujah. I want to change. Amen? Oh, hallelujah. Verse 12, restore to me the joy of your salvation. Amen? The joy of your salvation. Grant me a willing spirit to sustain me. Praise God. We just saw this powerful, powerful picture of what Lord Jesus Christ did to each one of us. Right? When we called on His name, God's hand, His only fingerprint, through Christ our Lord, He turns on that power. And His Holy Spirit. Amen? Holy Spirit, every one of you. I know, amen, I know who you are. I know who I am. Amen? Every one of you is a beloved child of God. You have the power. The eternal breath of God Almighty within you. Hallelujah. I like that sound effect. Amen. I pray I hear all over the world. Amen. The Lord Jesus Christ comes back even sooner. I'm so done with this world. Amen. It's His salvation. Hallelujah. His salvation. Lettuce. Say it with me. Lettuce. When we talk about lettuce, we're talking about the salvation of the Father, salvation of the Son, salvation of Holy Spirit. Brother Joey explained. Salvation of the Father consists of a Father that loves His children so much. But through sin, through disobedience, the children didn't want nothing to do with God. So in Father God's salvation, He looked upon His one and only Son. Sent His one and only Son. His one and only Son fulfilled every law that was required based from the very beginning when they said, let there be light. When they said, let us. When let us said, let there be light. The salvation of the Father is that Son had to die a horrible death. His blood was spilled on that cross for you and me. That blood is our new covenant. The salvation of the Father is, in 3 days, hallelujah, He rose His beloved Son from the grave. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The salvation of the Father is, now the Son sits at His right hand with all authority, with all power. His name is Lord Jesus Christ. And because of the obedience of that one Son, now there are many children in heaven. Can I get an amen? The salvation of the Son that we just celebrated in Easter week, right? That He left the Father. He left the Father. And He come with the rest of His brothers and sisters on this fallen world. Did not judge one of them. The salvation of the Son is, He just looked at them with eyes of mercy and grace. The salvation of the Son is, I bring you good news that we have a Father that loves us. And that everything that was being taught from the very beginning had to be said because I am here right now. The salvation of the Son is, I'm going to go through something unimaginable, excruciating pain. But I'm going to do it because you are worthy. The salvation of the Son is, He is so perfect that when He yielded up His spirit, Brother David, the veil that covered God was torn in half from the very top to the bottom. Can I get a hallelujah? Amen. Hallelujah. The salvation of the Spirit, hallelujah, the salvation of the Spirit is that He had nowhere to be that was perfect until the salvation of the Son occurred. That's the picture above our baptism. The salvation of the Spirit is in that anointing of Holy Spirit and fire, He rested and lived within a beloved child of God, baptized in Christ. Amen. The salvation of the Spirit is that when Lord Jesus Christ yielded Him up, Holy Spirit said, not only will I tear this veil in half, but in 3 days, I will raise you again. Let's give God praise. Amen. Say it with me, salvation.
Salvation.
See, when you look at agape, Father, Son, Holy Spirit, God Himself, and you look at the salvation that occurred from the Father's aspect, from the Son's aspect, from the Spirit's aspect. Now you're talking about lettuce. Now you're talking about my brain. We are a three-part being, right? Say it with me. I am an eternal soul. Say it with me. I am the body of Lord Jesus Christ. Say it with me. I am the temple of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Which means if anything's out of whack in this being right here, God has equipped us to attack those very things that try to come against us. The Word of God said, no weapon formed against us shall prosper. Which means that nothing. There's nothing that can come against you that will prosper. So why should we fear anything? Why should we fear? Is Jesus Christ Lord?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Where does Holy Spirit live? Hallelujah. Do we do everything we can to bless God and protect Him? Oh, hallelujah. Don't you love it? Now it's personal. Amen. Now you understand why a relationship with God, a relationship, not religion, now you understand why a relationship with God is not popular this day and age. It's not popular because it's easy to be religious with God. Okay, I just show up once a week and live the way I want to live. Punch the clock. Come on, beloved daughter of God. Right? That's why religion is so popular right now. Just live the way you want, but make sure you come to church. Rebuke that.
Amen.
Amen. Listen, God just done said it not too long ago. You got to either be hot or cold.
Amen.
Say it with me, there's a far.
There's a far.
Praise God. So Father, will I wait on God? The question is, will I wait on God? On the Son, will I hope only in Lord Jesus Christ? Will I hope only in Lord Jesus Christ? And Holy Spirit, will I trust in Him? These are the questions that God wants you to entertain throughout this worship service. When I say that I trust in salvation, what I am saying is I trust in agape. Who is agape? Oh, that's powerful now. Lord Jesus Christ said, those who believe in me don't only believe in me. Amen. But believes in the one who sent me. Right? God Almighty said through the mouth of Lord Jesus Christ, you say you believe in me? If you really believe in me, you don't just believe in me. You believe in the one who sent me. Which means if you believe in the one who sent him, you also believe in the one who is in him.
Amen.
Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. What does that trust look like? Are you guys curious?
Yes.
Amen. Let me show you what that trust looks like.
Hey.
You see, the glory of our God is that He says in the Word of God that we should soar like wings on eagles. And the only way you can soar is when you have your hands lifted on high. You see, this is a beautiful picture when you see it. An eagle just soaring. Is it worried about anything? God gave us the power to soar above any challenge, any distraction, any obstacle in our path. God gave us the ability, the anointing to soar over. Sometimes the biggest and saddest part is we choose not to lift our hands in worship. Yes, I'm physically doing right now so you can see my lovely wings. Amen. But what I'm talking about is your spiritual being, we said that we are temples of the Holy Spirit. Is your spirit man, is your spirit woman like this all the time?
Amen.
Can I hear an amen?
Amen.
Is your spirit man like this all the time, hallelujah? Don't get me wrong. Physically, this is hard to do. Right? I mean, even Moses struggled. They had to put something under to hold it up. Right? I'm just asking you, is your spirit being in worship, constantly mindful of Christ, blessing Holy Spirit in you, and allowing His anointing to flow through you? Can I get an amen?
Amen.
What does doubt look like? I want to show you what doubt looks like. Look at this. If you got the open sky, if you got the open sky, some of you know what's going to happen. If you got the open sky to fly, right? Say with me, I'm an eagle.
I'm an eagle.
Right? I'm an eagle. Hallelujah. I'm an eagle, and guess what? I'm just soaring above everything. My hands lifted high. Hallelujah. God provides the wind, and I just lift my hands, and he takes me over. But what does doubt look like? If you got the open sky right here, look at this. This little pipe, that's doubt. It don't look like much, right? It honestly don't even look like it's high enough, right, Mama, to cause any distraction. But let me show you. When you focus on doubt and not Jesus, when you focus on your worry, when you focus on what you want to be other than Jesus, let me show you what happens. All these other things from the enemy start to manifest in your life, trying to take your attention away from Jesus. Now let me ask you something. Does it look like an obstacle course? Huh? You notice when you focus on doubt, what takes place now? Anxiety starts to manifest. Glory to God, I have a pastor who loves me. Loves you guys, I know this. But he don't know nothing that I've been going through today. And in prayer, he just said, I rebuke any anxiety that's trying to come against my pastor. And I'm so thankful that I have a pastor to just rebuke him. Boom, right away, I'm just like, oh, thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. It's all the same with me, Holy Spirit. But when you focus on things like this, or you allow it to come in, the enemy starts putting all these obstacles in front of you. And this is what the enemy wants you to do. Let me show you what it looks like. Look at this screen. Hoping that, okay, I made it through this day. Oh, I did so good this day. Well, I'm doing all right. Oh, nothing. This is religion. This is religion trying to act like, okay, well, I'm going to do my best today. I'm going to do good today. I'm going to do this. You know the problem with that is? It's all I. But when your worship is, Father, I want to bless you today.
Amen.
Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Let's say gooder. Father, thank you for today. Father, thank you that Jesus is my Lord. Lord Jesus, through your Holy Spirit, give me the power to accomplish what you want for me today. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
What's the difference in that affirmation, in that confession? What's the difference versus, well, I'm going to do this. I'm going to do that. Oh, I want to start. I hear this all the time. I want to start coming to church. I want to start doing this. I want to start being thankful.
Amen.
Start thanking God for Lord Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Just start thanking God for Lord Jesus. Amen. I understand you want to come to church Sunday, but it's Monday. All right? You ain't come to church in 3 months. I'm not judging you, but you tell me this all the time. I just finished telling somebody this. You tell me this all the time. Listen, stop lying to me. Well, I'm not lying. Well, the fruit is you're not doing it. So stop saying those things if you don't mean it. Above all, stop lying to God because he hears you. And since it's Monday and Sunday is still a long ways away, why don't right now you just start thanking God for Jesus? And I promise you, you'll come to church Sunday. Amen, amen. We can find things to just complain about all the time. Can I get an amen? We can find something to complain about all the time. Seriously. Brother Jim, I can complain about everything. But does that blessed Holy Spirit in me? Amen, beloved Son of God. My brother knows. That won't do any good to Holy Spirit. Pastor, all it does is allow darkness to come in. And why would I allow that darkness to come into my life? Amen?
Amen.
Say with me, I trust in salvation.
I trust in salvation.
It leads us to all this, and we're going to close here soon. Praise God. Isaiah 40, verse 31. We're going to start on B. There's an A coming up. We're just going to start on B. They, say it with me, that's me.
That's me.
They will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. That's from 1 Kings, I believe, in chapter 48. When Elijah, hallelujah, when Elijah tucked in his cloak and he ran faster than the horse. Y'all remember that? Glory to God. Hallelujah. He tucked in his cloak and he ran faster than the horse. Hallelujah. Oh, come on now. He tucked in his... Some of us just need to tuck in our cloak and just go, huh? Hallelujah. horse to Jezreel. Are you for real? You're not Jezreel. They will walk and not be faint. Amen. They will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint. Say it with me, I trust in salvation. Hallelujah, I trust in salvation. But those who, what? But those who, what? In the Lord will renew their strength. Remember, the title is, it is what it is, right? It is what it is. I say it is, you say what? It is? It is. It is? It is. Louder. It is? It is? It is? It is? It is? It is? All right, so we discussed this. I trust in salvation. This is what? In this scripture, through all the different translations in the Bible, this is the word that comes in this scripture. Wait, hope, and trust.
Amen.
Wait, hope, and trust. Say it with me. Wait, hope, and trust. What does this mean? It is what it is. I wait on the Father. I hope only in Lord Jesus Christ. And I trust only in Holy Spirit anointing. God said clearly, in the anointing of Holy Spirit, if you're truly a born-again believer of Lord Jesus Christ, that means that you died when you received Him. I'm speaking to every soul here, and I'm speaking to every soul on Facebook, and every soul that's going to listen. If you did not die when you received Lord Jesus Christ, it's time to die. Say it with me, it's time to die.
Time to die.
Listen, I don't care how scary that sounds. I don't care how dark that sounds. It's the truth.
Amen.
You have to die in Christ in order to be resurrected.
Amen.
In order to live a born-again life. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. How many of you want to live a born-again life? Amen. Here, this is the thing. There's a lot of people that say, well, I've known Jesus. I've been baptized. I'm not judging nobody. But my question to you is, are you living the born-again life? Meaning that this world and everything that's in it has no pull and authority over you.
Amen.
Can I get an amen?
Amen.
If this is you, praise God. If this is you, raise your hand. That you live this way. Praise God. For those of you who didn't raise your hand, I pray in Jesus' name before this worship service order that you come up front and allow me or Pastor John to pray over you. And what will take place is on this glorious day, you will die. In Jesus' name, you will die because God right now is here with us and He knows that you're going to confess Him with all your heart.
Amen.
And you will be crucified in Christ, and in that very next breath, Holy Spirit anointing will overtake you, and you are a born-again child of God.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Do not leave here tonight. Do not leave here tonight until you know that for sure. That I died in Christ tonight. Amen.
Amen.
This world has nothing on me. You know why? This world has nothing to do with me. Amen. This is not my home. Amen.
Amen.
Salvation. I trust in salvation. What? Wait. Hope and trust. Amen. I trust in salvation. What? Wait. Hope and trust. Are you going to wait on God on that big decision that you're praying for? Are you going to wait on God on the desires of your heart? Or are you going to outstep God? Let me ask you something. If somebody does you wrong, are you going to wait on God to bless you, or are you just going to act on your own? Ooh. Ooh. Pastor went there. Yes, I did. Right? Yes, I did. Are you going to wait on God? Is your hope in yourself, or is your hope in Lord Jesus Christ?
Lord Jesus.
Amen?
Amen?
Amen? And do you trust Holy Spirit?
Yes.
Do you know that Holy Spirit is God?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Do you know that Holy Spirit is God? Do you know Holy Spirit? Right now, this world is blaspheming left and right. Blaspheming. Insulting Him. I'm so thankful to be surrounded by beloved children of God who bless Him because He came at such a high price.
Amen.
We saw what Lord Jesus Christ went through. Amen?
Amen?
See, when you truly live this way, that I trust in salvation, I trust in agape, that I wait on God, that I hope only in Lord Jesus Christ. And I trust in Holy Spirit. This is what God shows me in how your view of this life would be. You want a sword on wings like eagles?
Amen.
Do you want a sword above every obstacle of your life?
Amen.
Of every distraction of the enemy? Do you want a sword with your hands lifted high saying, Lord Jesus Christ, I only hope in you. I trust in you, Father. And I know that I will be victorious because you did it all. It's your salvation. You see, what God just wants to show us is just a little sneak peek of how God sees you and thinks of you. The power that he has put in you through his resurrection. That there's no need for you to live in torment. There's no reason for you to live with distraction upon distraction. Father God says, stop focusing on the doubt. Stop looking at the worry. Stop focusing on anxiety. Stop focusing on the goals. Stop focusing on the spouse. Stop focusing on the children. And just focus on Lord Jesus Christ. Yeah. Hallelujah. Yeah. And God promises that you will have this view. Hallelujah. To overcome every obstacle. Amen. I choose to soar on wings like eagles. This is what God is talking about. Amen. Now listen, just because you got feathers don't mean you're an eagle. Right? Just because you got feathers don't mean you're an eagle. Right? If you are grumbling, back talking, racist, unforgiving, your fruit says you got feathers, but you a chicken. That's what your fruit tells me. Yeah. I will pray for you. I will pray that the crucifixion of Lord Jesus Christ becomes so real in your life that you know, I can't have this hatred in my heart. My God died for everybody. It doesn't matter the color of their skin.
Amen.
It doesn't matter as far as what they did wrong to me. I want to pray for them. If you're not bold, if you're ashamed of Lord Jesus Christ, if you're ashamed of being a Christian, or you act like a Christian, but then in the privacy of your own home, you act like a demon, I'm going to tell you right now, you're an ostrich. You're in denial. You're in your own world with your head stuck in the ground. Get your head up out of the ground, amen? Listen, I'm not judging you, I'm just saying. Tonight, God wants every soul in you to soar on wings of eagles. Amen?
Amen?
Let's all stand up on our feet. Praise God. We got a couple songs that are going to play tonight. Pastor, I'm going to ask you to come up, please. Everybody, let's give God praise that our pastor's back home. Amen? Hallelujah. Let's give God praise that pastor's back. Man, it's been a long 2 weeks. I missed him. Love him with all my heart. Amen.
Amen.
You didn't raise your hand earlier. This is the time now. Pastors here, I'm here. We want to anoint you in oil, and we want to say a prayer over you and with you. You're going to say this prayer, and you are going to die tonight. You are going to die tonight. And Holy Spirit will resurrect you, I promise you. Amen. The glory of God is if you die and you're physically dead, hallelujah, your next breath is with the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah, praise God. Hallelujah. This world ain't got nothing on us, amen. But I pray that if you're not one of those that did not raise your hand and you did raise your hand, I pray that you bless agape in a way that you haven't before. Maybe Holy Spirit has exposed something that's going on right now in your life that you know, I got carried away. I've been short-tempered. I shouldn't have. Maybe been impatient. That's not Holy Spirit fruit. Maybe you've become selfish. Right? Whatever it is, Holy Spirit's giving me a list of things. And I'm asking right now, no, I won't do it. Maybe pornography has entered your house. Maybe you start looking at something that you're not supposed to be looking at. Maybe that there's lust right now that you know that I don't know why I'm being torn. I want to tell you why. Darkness has crept in. Right now, tonight, Holy Spirit wants to rebuke that through His presence. And it only takes place through His holy blood. Will you receive that tonight? Amen?
Amen.
I beg you, beloved church family, if you may be one of the very, very few that says, everything's good and good, or I ain't got nothing, please, still come and pray. Amen? It's not for me. It's not for me. Hear me now. If nobody comes, it doesn't matter. Just between you and God. But I'm going to tell you, I know what I need to do at this altar. Amen?
Amen.
And the altar is always open, so please come. In Jesus' name, amen?